Sizzling sunshine is in the forecast until further notice. All right, there it is. Big hurricane threatening the Carolinas. Dorian Fernand made landfall and will dissipate over Mexico. Hot, high pressure in between the two is the controlling weather factor for us. And you can see all the water vapor. See all that orange? That's very dry air over the Gulf Coast region. That is going to continue. By the way, we got three storms now. And you may think that is unusual. It really isn't. During the hurricane season, this happens maybe every other year. So about 50% of the time, once every 2 years, we have three named storms at the same time. None of the tropical activity is going to threaten our area. The Gulf and the Caribbean looking clear right now. Dallas is 95. Atlanta is 96. Nashville, 95. That's that hot, high pressure. Look at that. Destin, 97 right now. Temperatures in the mid-90s. This is going to continue. The weather pattern's not going to change for the next week and a half. And let's see what the real field numbers look like. Well, 95 to 100, nothing too serious. This is going to be the trend. We do have some drier air trying to mix in on the backside of the hurricane, so that should keep the real field numbers under control, even though it's going to continue to be in the middle and upper 90s. Here you can see the lows by morning, right around 70 degrees. Here's the latest on Hurricane Dorian. Still a storm that looks like it's going to threaten the Carolinas to me. And I think sometime late tomorrow it'll be very close to the South Carolina coastline. Storm is a little bit better organized today. All the hurricane force winds are still offshore. Savannah, Charleston are seeing winds of 30 to 40 miles per hour right now. The weather will deteriorate up on the South Carolina coast as that does approach. It looks like it'll still hold its intensity, Dorian, for another day or so, and then gradually decrease as it heads out into the Atlantic Ocean. Great look at the radar. Some outer bands affecting the Carolinas. Again, weather will be deteriorating tonight into Thursday across South Carolina and then eventually up into North Carolina. As far as Savannah, you'll probably see 40, 50 mile an hour winds in that area, but look at the winds really picking up tomorrow along the South Carolina coast as the hurricane center will be moving very close to the coast. And then as we head into Friday, it's going to get picked up by a trough and set out into the Atlantic, and then it will zip out and speed away very, very quickly. So the threats are 50 to 80 mile per hour wind gusts along the Carolina coastline. And there you see the forecast track, and there'll be a storm surge as well. Rainfall totals look like they could be in the 5 to 10 inch range. For us, hot, drier weather continues. Northerly winds helping with the drier air. There's just no change in our pattern, I think, until the middle of the month. Warm and humid, clear skies, 71 tonight. Tomorrow, I think we'll top out right around 95, 96 again. Real field, in some spots, could be over 100, but like today, dry air mixing in. Real feel is held in the upper 90s in some spots. So upper 90s, right above 100 for the real feel. There it is. No change, but maybe by the end of next week, in a week and a half, we'll see a change in the pattern.